فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
نعم. So we were speaking about نبي الله إبراهيم هو خليل الله. He's the وقال إبراهيم هو خليل الله ونبيه الكريم. When he said ولكن ليطمئن قلبي, we said that this is على سبيل الامتناع, meaning that it's impossible for Ibrahim عليه السلام to have actually doubted Allah تبارك وتعالى being able to create. Some scholars, they said ولكن ليطمئن قلبي, so my heart can find tranquility. In other words, what Imam Ibrahim was saying was that ليزداد يقيني, so my certainty can increase. I already have certainty, I just want my certainty to increase even more. Does that make sense? So this is why Imam al-Bukhari is bringing it here, meaning that al-Iman yazidu wa yanqus. And the reason why he brought the statement of or the second statement which he brings, which is waqala Mu'adh, and Mu'adh here is who? Mu'adh ibn Jabal al-Sahabi al-Jalil. Mu'adh ibn Jabal is a noble companion, and he was a alim, a scholar, Mu'adh. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw by Allah al-ala annahu yuhibbu. The Prophet said to him, inni la uhibbuk, wallahi inni la uhibbuk. The Prophet said this to Mu'adh. And then when he said to him, I love you, what did he say after that? فَلَا تَدْعَنَّ أَن تَقُولَ فِي دُبُرِ الصَّلَاةِ اللَّهُمَا إِنِّي عَلَى ذِكْرِكَ وَشُكْرِكَ وَحُسْنُ عِبَادَتِكَ. Wallahi, I love you. And do not leave off saying after you finish the prayer or at the ending of the prayer. Scholars, they differ what the word dubur means. Does it actually mean you say this dua after you say salam alaikum, salam alaikum? Do you say it then? Or do you say it at the ending of the, after you say your tahiyyat and some scholars, within the salah, like it. There's a difference between khilaf on it. Ala kulli hal, the Prophet said, I love you, Mu'adh. Say at the ending of the prayer, Allahumma a'inni, oh Allah, aid me and support me, ala dhikrika, in your remembrance, ala dhikrika wa shukrika, in your gratitude, wa husn ibadatika, and the perfection of your worship. Now this benefit that comes here right now, my beloved brothers and sisters, when the Prophet told Mu'adh that he loved him, what did he do? He told him the truth. And he told him something that will benefit him. It is deception that you see somebody doing innovation, and you see somebody going against Allah's command, and you say, I love him, but I'm not going to tell him. Sah? You love a person, and you see him going against Allah's command, and you see him committing sins, and the worst of sins is innovation. Because the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, what did he say? We say in the khutbatul hajj, what did we say? Inna sharra al-umuri muhdathatuha. That the worst of affairs is the newly introduced matter. That's the worst. It's worse than zina, it's worse than killing. It's always, sah? Are you with me, brothers? So you see somebody dwelling inside innovation, you shouldn't be quiet. Because the Prophet, when he loved Mu'adh, what did he say? Wallahi inna inni la uhibbuk. Fala tada'anna. He's teaching him something that will benefit him. So your love has to mean that you benefit those who are around you. And then, a bit more about Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said about Mu'adh ibn Jabal, inna Mu'adhan kana, Mu'adh is ummah. Mu'adh by himself is a nation. He's an ummah, he himself. He said that. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said that about him, as Bukhari narrated it, and also al-Imam Muslim brought it. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, you find it by al-Imam al-Tabarani, al-Imam ibn Jarir al-Tabari, in his tafsir. He brings it in the ayah, inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanitan lillahi. He brings it in the ayah. Ibrahim is an ummah, he brings the statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud that he said the same about Mu'adh ibn Jabal. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, istaqra'u al-Qur'ana min arba'atin. Take the Qur'an from four people. And from the four that the Prophet mentioned was who? Mu'adh ibn Jabal. So Mu'adh is somebody whose caliber is very high. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, inna Mu'adh ibn Jabal amam al-ulama'i ratwatun. That Mu'adh is he is ahead of the ulama and the scholars. He's ahead of them. Ratwa means rami al-hajara. When you throw a rock, how far it reaches, he's that high. However far you can throw, that's how far he is from them. I mean, he's in front of all the ulama that you can think of. Now again, Bukhari bringing the qawl of Mu'adh ibn Jabal is mu'allaq. Meaning, Bukhari never met Mu'adh. Are you with me? And we said that the mu'allaq means that مَا حُذِفَ مِن مَبْدَئِ السَّنَدِ. When the beginning of the chain of narration is this, is Bukhari doesn't mention his sheikh. Who did Bukhari hear it from? Who is his sheikh? This is called mu'allaqat. And we know, as the scholars of hadith mention, أَنَّ الْمُعَلَّقَاتِ فِي الْبُخَارِيَةِ فِي الْبُخَارِي, the mu'allaqat, those narrations that are like that in Sahih al-Bukhari, laysat ala shartihi, it's not of the conditions of Imam al-Bukhari. Because sometimes the mu'allaqat can be what? Ma huwa sahihun, wa ma huwa da'ifun, wa ma huwa hasanun. All of them are present in it. What did Mu'adh ibn Jabal say? Ijlis bina nu'minu sa'ah. Ma ma'ana nu'minu sa'ah? Nuqawwi imanana. Come, let's sit down and let's strengthen our iman and make our iman strong for a little bit. But how is he going to do that? Bidhikrillah, with the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and studying the book of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, and anything like that. So my beloved brothers and sisters, what we take from this is what? What we take from this is that reading the Quran, remembering Allah, iman increases. Just by sitting here, inshallah ta'ala, inshallah your iman will increase. And if you go outside and you play around and you hang around with the wrong crowd of people, your iman will what? Decrease. So there are factors that increase your iman. Somebody will come up to you and say, "Akhi, my iman is low." The answer is not rocket science. Is it? What is it that you're doing that's making your iman decrease? Stay away from it. That's not something I can make you stay away from. That's not what I can make you stay away from. And then he brings a statement of وَقَالَ عَبْدُ ibn Mas'ud. Again, this is a mu'allaq. Bukhari didn't mean Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he's who? Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He's the noble companion. He's a sahabiyun jaleel. وَلِذَلِكَ, if the name Abdullah is said like that, just Abdullah, it should hit your mind. No one else should come to your mind. It shouldn't be Ibn Abbas. It shouldn't be Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As. It shouldn't be Abdullah ibn Zayd. No other Abdullah should come to your mind. عند الاطلاق, scholars of hadith, when they say عن عبد الله قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, you know, you need to know this Abdullah is Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was the most knowledgeable man in tafsir when he was alive. He said, ما من آية في كتاب الله إلا وأنا أعلم أين نزلت ومتى نزلت وفيما نزلت ولو كنت أعلم أحدا أعلم مني بكتاب الله تقطعه المطايا من الإبل لركبت إليه ولا ذهبت إليه. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, there's not ayah that came down, except I know who came down and where it came down and when it came down, and all of it pertaining to it. And if I was to know anyone more knowledgeable than me than the book of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and I can go to him and I can take it from him, I would, but there isn't. So some scholars said, was he more knowledgeable than Abdullah ibn Abbas? Na'am, when he was alive. That's what Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentions in his Majmu' al-Fatawa. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he was from the what? Min as-sabiqina ila al-Islam, from the early people who entered Islam. And he was, as he said, min aqrabin nasi samtan wa hadiyan, the one who most appeared and looked like, imitated the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, in terms of how he was hadiyan and how he was dallan, the way he carried himself and everything for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And as I said to you, he was an alim of the Quran and he memorized the Quran. What did he say? Al yaqeen ul iman kullu, that the yaqeen, certainty, is all of iman. What does he mean, it's all of iman? He means that it is aslul iman. And the asl of the iman is the real essence of your iman. That's what he means. What he means, al-iman, al-yaqeenu, that yaqeen is al-imanu kullu, all of iman. He means that yaqeen, certainty, is aslul iman. And aslul iman is the real essence of your iman. That's what he means. Because if a person has yaqeen in his heart, فَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ تَبَعٌ لِذَلِكَ صح? Everything follows up your certainty. If you have doubt in your heart, then you won't. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا وَجَاهَدُوا. The jihad only came, ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا, when they didn't have doubt in their hearts. صح? But if you have doubt in your heart, you won't learn, and you won't benefit. وَلِذَلِكَ, what did the poet say? إِذِ الْفَتَى حَسْبَ اعْتِقَادِهِ رُفِعُ وَكُلُّ مَا لَمْ يَعْتَقِدْ لَمْ يَنْتَفِعُ. If you're studying with a sheikh and you don't trust him, you don't believe in him, you don't have faith in your sheikh, are you going to benefit from him? You have doubt in him. Are you going to benefit from him? You're not. إِذِ الْفَتَى حَسْبَ اعْتِقَادِهِ رُفِعُ. Just because of what you believe of an individual you're learning from can make you... Because when you think this person... And like some people say to you, I'm going to study from an innovator, I'm just going to take the good and the bad. If you're in a situation where you're checking him and you're, I need to be careful, if he says this, I have to be away from him, then you're not benefiting from him, are you really? The person you're learning from, your heart should just be open for him. Just throw everything, I'm taking it. Sah? Because you trust him, right? A person you don't trust, it's like saying, my doctor, I don't trust him when he's doing surgery on me, so I just keep one eye open. Just make sure he doesn't do the surgery bad. I keep an eye open. I'm just making sure that everything's being done correctly. The way that you laugh at that is the same way of this. It's nothing different. Is there a difference? So what he means is that the yaqeen is the asl of the iman. It's in the iman, just like the Prophet ﷺ said, "Ala wa inna fil jasadi mudghah, idha salahat salaha al-jasadu kull, idha fasadat fasada al-jasadu kull, ala wa hiya al-qalb." The heart, what's the asl for it, is yaqeen. And once the yaqeen is in the heart, then it starts showing on the limbs. That's exactly what the statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is, radiyallahu ta'ala. And then he goes, وَقَالَ ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab, he's a companion, so is his father a companion, radiyallahu ta'ala. And he was Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab, the Prophet referred to him as a what? He's a rajulun salih, righteous man. Abdullah ibn Umar, the Prophet referred to him as a righteous man. You're a righteous man. What did Abdullah ibn Umar say? Please, my youngsters, remember this. What did Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu say? He said, La yablugu al-abdu, a slave does not reach haqiqatu taqwa. You are truly not going to reach, you're not going to reach the reality of piety. You want to be a person who's a muttaqi. You want to reach the reality of taqwa. How do you reach that? Hatta yada'a ma haka fi sadrik. You have to leave off ma haka fi sadr, ay ma yataraddadu ila sadr. A lot of people will come up to you today and they'll say to you, Akhi, is this permissible? Why is it that you asked me if this is permissible and not all the other things you could have asked me? Sah? Why did you choose to ask? Would anybody ever come up to you and say, Akhi, is it permissible for me to get married? Would anybody ask you that question? But they'll come up to you and they'll ask you, brother, is it permissible for me to talk to a sister without her willy knowing? The fact that it's regurgitated and it's something your heart keeps questioning, it shows you that is what? As the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Al-ithmu ma haka fi sadrik wa karihta an yattali' alayhi nas. A sin is what keeps coming to your mind like, oh, I don't know, I'm skeptic about this. It doesn't feel good. And you dislike the people seeing you in it. You see? The Prophet says, alayhi salatu wasalam. So when you know that you've reached the seriousness of taqwa and iman, is when you, the things that you think, oh, I'm going to leave it. I don't want something, I'm going to feel like that. Yeah? With that, Hassan al-Basri, he said, summiya ahlu taqwa, summiya al-muttaqeen, that the people of taqwa were called people of taqwa. Why? لِأَنَّهُمْ تَرَكُوا كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْحَلَالِ مَخَافَةَ الْحَرَامِ. The people of taqwa were called ahlu taqwa because they left a lot of things that were halal because of fearing that they might fall into haram. They left halal. Yeah. For us, anybody who tells you, I stay away from haram, for us, that's taqi. Sah? These people left things that were halal. They were like, is it halal? I'm not saying it's haram, I just don't want to do it. This is what the scholars called ahlul wara. They're called what? Ahlul wara. And then it's basically, da' ma yaribuka ila ma la yaribuka. Anything that gives you doubt, get away from it and go to that which doesn't give you doubt. Naam. وقال مجاهد ابن جبر, he brings this statement. مجاهد ابن جبر العالم المكي, he's what? مولى بني مخزوم. He was a slave for the people of Bani Makhzum. And he was what? صاحب عبد الله بن عباس. He was a student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. And he is imam من أئمة أهل التفسير. ولذلك سفيان الثوري, he said, إذا جاءك تفسير مجاهد فحسبك به. If the tafsir of Mujahid comes to you, that's enough. Don't ask anybody any other questions. If Mujahid gives you tafsir of an ayah, that's enough for you. Don't ask for anything. Radiallahu anhu. And he is min rijali kutub sita. You find him in the 6 books of hadith. Bukhari, Muslim, Abi Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i. He said, shara'a lakum. Where did he get that from? He got that from قوله تعالى شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك كما وصينا بإبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. He got it from the ayah in Surah Shura, ayah 31, Surah Shura. So he said, شرع لكم, Allah has legislated for you. Mujahid saying this. وَإِيَّاهُ. And here, Mujahid says, وَإِيَّاهُ. But the ayah, if you look at it, شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك كما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى. So why is he saying إياه بضمير إفراد? He's using a pronoun that was singular when it should have been a pronoun which is plural. He should have said وإياهم. Maybe he's only referring to نوح عليه السلام. And once he affirms it for نوح, then it's a domino effect. All of it will go for everyone else. Huh? It's not that I play domino. Okay? But that if he affirms it for Nuh, then it will be affirmed for everybody else. What is that? What is it? Mujahid said, شَرَعَ لَكُمْ مِنَ أَوْصَيْنَاكَ يَا مُحَمَّدٍ. Muhammad, we have the word wasiyah, what is it? What's the best translation for it? Farewell? Bequest? Command? Naam. Ya Muhammad, we've commanded you, O Muhammad, wa iyahu and Nuh alayhi salam, and all the other prophets, deen and wahid, and one religion. Ikhwani, all the prophets, they have one religion. There was one religion they had all in common, which is a tawheed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. Every prophet before you, Muhammad, and you, they were sent this same message, لا إله إلا الله, call to that. Does that make sense? Now brothers, Nabiullah Nuh, how many years was he calling his people for? I'm asking you a question. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَى قَوْمِ فَلَبِثَ فِيهِمْ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. How many years is that? 900? What do you know about his da'wah? Only Tawheed, right? Wallahi brothers, that's shocking. A prophet was calling his people for 950 years, and all we know that he called to his people too was what? يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُهُ. Ibrahim, Nabi Nuh, 950 years, all we know he said to his people was, worship Allah alone and don't associate partners with him. That shows you, wallahi, that if this is a Nabi, 950 years, the only thing that was told to us about his life, that he quoted Tawheed, it shows you a da'i who is not distinct like that. Who's not known to call the people to Tawheed. And he's not known to call the people to the Aqeedah, Sahihah, then something wrong. What are you calling the people to? What's your da'wah about? If your da'wah, the assas of it, it's not Tawheed, then what's the foundation for your da'wah? Look at every prophet that came to these people. Ya qawmi ibudullaha ma lakum min ilahin ghayru. Brothers, you guys have heard of the hadith where the Prophet told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, there's going to come a time when a person will hear la ilaha illallah, what's he going to say? What's he going to say? A person's going to hear la ilaha illallah, and he's going to say, oh, I heard my forefathers say this. When will this happen, brothers? When the scholars stop talking about la ilaha illallah. If it becomes, okay, everyone knows that, leave it. Just put, everybody's, we all agree that. And you just leave it there. Then everybody starts talking about politics and siyasa and all BBC, what happened yesterday? Somebody got shot here, somebody. We all talk about that, and that's what we retweet and we, yeah? And then we forget about the tawheed. There's going to come generations who, that book you closed, they won't know about it. Wallahi, that's how it's going to happen. So this should always be mentioned in manabir khutbatul jum'ah. Every opportunity a person gets. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling it to Nabi Abdullah ibn Abbas, Ya Ghulam, Inni u'allimuka kalimat, ihfadhi Allah yahfadhuk. Ihfadhi Allah tajidhu tujak. Idha sa'alta fas'ali Allah. Don't ask anyone, Ibn Abbas. He's a little kid. You know how old Ibn Abbas was when the Prophet died? 13. 13 when the Prophet died. So he must be younger than 13 at that time. Are you with me, brothers? So the da'i, the person who's giving da'wah to the people, he needs to be distinct, he needs to be known for what? If you look at today, the problem that we're having in this community and society, wallahi, the asal for it is aqeedah. Bad tawheed. I'll tell you that right now. صح؟ هربوا من الرق الذي خلقوا له فبلوا برق النفس والشيطان. People are slaves for their nafs and shaytan. Isn't that servitude for other than Allah? Isn't that aqeedah you need to teach them? أفرأيت من اتخذ إلهه هوا. His ilah is هوا. He worships his own whims and desires. His whims and desires tells him to go right. He goes, okay, I'm going to go right. Allah tells him, he says, like, you know, it's 21st century. Brothers, anyone who tells you within the Muslim community there's the aqeedah is strong and mashallah, there's no need to talk about this topic all the time, is a person who does not know the reality of the Muslims. صح? Look what Allah says in the Quran. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنْكُمْ وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنْكُمْ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. I will give you victory. I will give you istikhlaf. I will make you guys governors on this earth. I made you leaders on this earth. But I need something from you. What is it? يَعْبُدُونَنِي يُوَشْمِي أَلَوْنَ لَا تُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. Don't associate partners with me. إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in another ayah. الذين إن مكناهم في الأرض أقاموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأمروا بالمعروف ونهوا عن المنكر ولله عاقبة الأمور. الذين إن مكناهم, the people we make solid on this earth, we make them steadfast on this earth, are people who have these characteristics. What are they? They establish a prayer. الذين مكناهم في الأرض أقاموا الصلاة. They establish a prayer. وآتوا الزكاة. They give zakat. وأمروا بالمعروف. They call each other to the good and they prohibit each other from the evil. إخواني, as a da'i, your da'wah is not about what people like. It's not about that. Forget that. Leave that alone. What people like. Your job is actually to cure people's problems. If your aunt, your mom came to you today, a doctor prescribed a medicine for her. A doctor prescribed something for her. And your mom doesn't like the taste of the medicine. Are you going to force that medicine on your mom? And it's her health. Are you? Your mom is sick. Doctor has given her a medicine. This medicine is going to help her. Your mom does not like the taste of the medicine. She's like, leave me. Don't give it to me. And what are you going to do? Are you going to force it down her? You're going to force it with her. Allah even allows you to do that. That's why Allah says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُل لَّهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُل لَّهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا وَاخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُل رَّبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. رَبُّكُمْ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا فِي نُفُوسِكُمْ. That if you sometimes go against your parents, Allah knows what's in your heart. That if you're doing it for their good. Are you there? So you're going to force your mom. Are you doing her a favor? But she doesn't like it. But you're doing something you know that's good for her. Why is it not? The ummah who are suffering from bad aqeedah and tawheed. Brothers, are you paying attention here? That when they get angry, you should just ignore it. Because what you know you're doing is what? You're doing what's good for them. They hate you for it, labas. There's a hadith of the Prophet, hadith of Ibn Abbas, which is Sahih Muslim. يأتي نبي وليس معه أحد. A prophet is going to come and there's nobody with him. That's, your job is not who follows you. Your job is إنما عليك البلاغ. لست عليهم بمسيطر. Your job is not to place the haq in the people's hearts. You convey the message. Don't deceive them. It shocks me because a person who calls to da'wah, for 10 years a person of innovation is sitting with him, and not one day does the innovator find out that what he's upon is an innovation, you're hiding it from him. And you're like, I just don't want to cause division. What do you call this person sitting next to you every day is writing from you? You're talking to him about fiqh issues. You're talking to him about masail nahu. You're talking to him about sarf. You're talking to him about balagha. He's sitting with you every day. He's writing notes from you and he's benefiting from you. And you're not one day said to him, Akhi, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is above his throne. That's wrong what you believe of Allah. You've not once said it to him. What's he going to do to you the day of judgment? You deceived me. Allah says to the Quran, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ لَتُبَيِّنُنَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَكْتُمُونَ. Allah took a covenant with those who know that they're going to convey the matter. Tell the people the truth. مَنْ سُئِلَ عَنْ عِلْمٍ فَكَتَمَهُ أُلْجِمَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ بِلِجَامٍ مِنْ نَارٍ. Anybody who's asked about a knowledge, he knows it. It's clear to him. أخي, say it. But na'am, one thing we have to do is the way we say it, the way we put the message through to the people, it should be in softness, observing, you know, kindness. But the message should not be compromised. And it should be said, the truth should be told to the people. But it should be said in a very wise, in a very smart, in a very mature manner. So that's what the people mix up with. They want the message to go with the maturity and the wiseness. It's not right. Are you with me? When the Prophet came, alayhi salatu wasalam, what did he say to them? To the kuffar of Quraysh. What did he say? What did he say to them? He said, all of your forefathers are in the hellfire. Did he say that? Yeah? That's what he said to them. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told them when he came to Mecca that all of your parents, even mine included, he said alayhi salatu wasalam, that they're in the hellfire. This is what Allah said. ولذلك Abu Talib, he said, وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُ بِأَنَّ دِينَ مُحَمَّدٍ خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ دِينَ لَوْلَا الْمَلَامَةُ أَوْ حِدَارَ مُسَبَّتٍ لَوَجَدْتَنِي بِذَاكَ سَبْحًا مُبِينًا. If it was not for the fact that my family will rebuke me, and if it wasn't for my forefathers, because if he takes Islam, Abu Talib is going to have to believe Abdul Muttalib is in hellfire. That was hurting him. He couldn't live a life of knowing that my father is going to be in the hellfire. Does that make sense? But did the Prophet say, I'm going to have to hide this? Did he hide it? Brothers, it's important, wallahi. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam conveyed the message. He told the people the tawheed and the aqeedah. He taught them, and he did it in a wise way. May Allah make us those who are wise in their da'wah and the way they say things. وقال ابن عباس, Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, رضي الله تعالى عنه, may Allah be pleased with him. And Abdullah ibn Abbas is Abdullah ibn Abbas. شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا. What does it mean, شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا? It means سَبِيلَةً وَسُنَّةً. شِرْعَةً means سَبِيلًا. مِنْهَاجًا is what? The shir'atan is sabilan. Wa minhajan is a sunnatan. The Prophet is sunnah. Na'am.
باب دعاؤكم إيمانكم. حدثنا عبيد الله بن موسى قال أخبرنا حنظلة بن أبي سفيان عن إكرمة ابن خالد عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بني الإسلام على خمس: شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة والحج وصوم رمضان.
Chapter: Your invocation means your faith. Narrated by Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Islam is based on five: to testify that la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, that none has the right to be worshipped but Allah, and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah; to perform the prayer; to pay zakat; to perform hajj; and to observe fasting during the month of Ramadan.
Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he says, Babu du'a'ukum imanukum. This bab, the strongest opinion, and inshallah ta'ala that which we take, is that this is not a bab. And that Bukhari didn't place this bab. And it happened in some of the nusak, some of the copies of Sahih al-Bukhari. Na'am, read the Hamish for us. Which riwayah did it happen in? At the bottom.
Li Abi Dhar wa alayhi sah li qawlihi.
The riwayah to Abi Dhar was one of the narrations that have come.
Lost bab saqata 'inda ibn Asakir.
Na'am. So the riwayah that has come to us, which is the riwayah Abi Dhar, it mentions that it doesn't mention babu. Sah? The riwayah Abi Dhar doesn't mention the babin. So that's the strongest one. Because look, this is still the statement of Ibn Abbas that we were just mentioning. Didn't Ibn Abbas say when he was mentioning shir'ata wa minhaja qul ma ya'ba'u bikum rabbi lawla du'a'ukum faqad kadhabtum fasawfa yakunu lizama. He says قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاءُكُمْ. He says, دُعَاءُكُمْ إِيمَانُكُمْ. He was commenting on that verse.
Ibn Asakir is the one who dropped it.
نعم, the riwayah Ibn Asakir mentions, drops it out. But the riwayah Ibn Dhar mentions it. And even the copy that he's using, which is Dar al-Ta'seel, they bring it in. But as the strongest of the mistake is that the majority of the scholars, they make it weak, the opinion of saying بَابُ دُعَاءُكُمْ إِيمَانُكُمْ. It shouldn't be a bab. There's no bab here. We're still on the same first bab. Then Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he says, حَدَّثَنَا عُبَيْدُ اللَّهِ ibn Musa. His name is عُبَيْدُ اللَّهِ ibn Musa ibn al-Mukhtar al-Abisiyu Abu Muhammad al-Kufiyu, and he's very well known as Badam. He's very well known as the name Badam. مِنْ ثِقَّةِ, he's very reliable. مِنْ رِجَالِ الْجَمَاعَةِ, and he's from the طَبَقَةِ التَّاسِعَة, the ninth level, I think, if I'm not wrong. He said, أخبرنا حنظلة ابن أبي سفيان. His name is حنظلة ابن أبي سفيان ابن عبد الرحمن ابن صفوان ابن أمية الجمحي. ثقة, he's reliable. حجة, من رجال الجماعة. He's from the six books of hadith. All six of hadith, they've narrated from him. حنظلة ابن أبي سفيان, you'll find him there. عن عكرمة ابن خالد. Now عكرمة ابن خالد, we need to observe him a little bit because there are two عكرمة's and that people confuse one another with each other. The first one is what? عكرمة ابن خالد ابن سعد ابن العاص ابن هشام ابن المغيرة المخزومي. That one, he's reliable, and that's the one that Bukhari narrated from over here. There's another one by the name of عكرمة ابن خالد ابن سلمة. ابن سلمة ابن هشام ابن المغيرة المخزومي. And the second one, which is أبي سلمة, he is ضعيف. His narration is not taken, so it's not accepted. So don't confuse the two with one another. Okay? And if you go to the kitab written by Al-Imam Ibn Hajar Al-Asqalani, Taqrib Al-Tahdhib, one of the benefits that you find from it is that these are the kind of things he points out. Al-Imam Ibn Hajar, he's wrote a book called Taqrib Al-Tahdhib, which is originally taken from the kitab Tahdhib Al-Kamal, written by Al-Hajjaj Al-Mizzi rahimahullah. And what he does is that Al-Imam Ibn Hajar, he writes in brackets Tamyiz, Ta, Mim, Ya, Ya, and then Za at the end, which basically means that he'll kind of distinguish men's names who are similar to one another. And he'll say, these two people are mainly confused with one another, be careful. Bukhari narrates from this one, and he never ever narrated from this one. And these are the benefits that you get from this kitab of Ibn Hajar, which is Taqrib al-Tahdhib, in which he has authored, rahimahullah ta'ala. So that's just the issue of the chain of narration.